Hi guys, Lisette here for Tool Tester. WordPress has long been known as the best website builder for blogging, but recently many designers have argued in favor of Webflow. So who takes the blogging crown? Let's take a closer look and compare Webflow to WordPress. If you're looking for something that's easier to use than WordPress, then Webflow may not be the right tool for you. It's true that it's more intuitive than WordPress because you can see the changes you make in real time, but the number of customization options makes it overwhelming. Webflow is recommended if you're a designer or user with more advanced skills. Ideally, you have some CSS and HTML knowledge. With this background, you'll be able to get the most out of Webflow and make use of Webflow University, which offers a ton of helpful tutorials, articles, and a community forum. When it comes to setup, Webflow is simpler though. With WordPress, you first need to find a hosting provider and install it yourself. Its extensions and plugins are great, but they're not always easy to maintain. In fact, you need to keep an eye out for any required plugin updates, as well as updates released by WordPress itself. What's more, a simple update can drastically change your website's appearance. WordPress is moving in a user-friendly direction with the Gutenberg update that added a building block editor, but it's still a far cry away from other popular website builders like Wix. When it comes to design and flexibility, Webflow offers a few options. To create your website, you can either start from scratch or start with one of their templates. You can choose from around 500 code-free, beautiful-looking templates. Some are free, and the premium templates run between $19 and $149. You can sort them by categories, style, features, or even type, such as basic, CMS, or e-commerce. Webflow also makes it easy to set up your website for mobile. The editor lets you customize and preview your site for different screen sizes. While existing code can't be imported to Webflow, you can import the content of your existing WordPress site and manually recreate your website design in Webflow. With WordPress, however, its design and flexibility offerings are pretty straightforward. If you know CSS and HTML, you can get exactly the kind of website you want. There are tons of responsive WordPress themes online, which run between $30 and $60. So when it comes to flexibility and designs, we tend to prefer WordPress over Webflow, though Webflow does offer great templates. Now let's get to the meat of it, blogging features. Webflow gives you a ton of creative freedom to set up a blog with its builder. However, you do have to integrate all the features manually, so it isn't the simplest process. If you have zero design experience, you might find this tricky. On the other hand, WordPress was originally designed for blogging, which means it natively comes with all the popular blogging features. And you can use plugins to add in any extra features you might need, such as anti-spam comments or a multilingual blog. Its editor also lets you manage content in both visual and HTML mode. Due to its simpler yet flexible approach, we're going to have to go with WordPress here. Moving on to plugins. Webflow offers a whole host of integrations with everything from CRM to email marketing tools. Curiously, Webflow actually offers a plugin that allows you to build your pages in Webflow and serve them directly onto your WordPress site. This is great if you want to keep your site on WordPress but use an alternative editor. Now, WordPress is well known for its plugins. It offers a ton of options. However, some can be pretty costly, and you might need a bit of technical knowledge to install and update them. For example, WPML is Tool Tester's own plugin to manage multiple languages. It's very powerful, though this means it's also complicated to maintain. If you can't find what you're looking for, WordPress gives you full access to the code, so you can hire a developer to create a plugin for you or build it yourself. WordPress takes this point once again here due to its breadth of plugins. Okay, to sum up, here are the two main reasons Webflow would work well for you. If you're an advanced user, Webflow might be in your sweet spot. Because it's a blend of a classic website builder and a CMS, Webflow is slightly easier to use for highly technical or advanced solutions. Or if you're a designer with little to no coding experience, you will appreciate the more visual editor and extensive customization options. And here are the two main reasons WordPress might be better for you. If you're working on a big project that keeps evolving, WordPress's extensive plugins and themes will give you the flexibility and control you need. Or, if your website largely focuses on e-commerce, WordPress integrates perfectly with WooCommerce. Now, the main reason why you might shy away from Webflow is if you're planning to rely heavily on plugins. Although Webflow has a decent amount available, its range is much more limited compared to WordPress. Speaking of WordPress, here are the two main reasons you might avoid it. If you need support and don't have a team, WordPress won't be very helpful as there's no official support available. Or if you're not technologically savvy, WordPress might be too complex for you to use as you may have to edit HTML or CSS. The bottom line is Webflow has some amazing advantages, but if you're not afraid to learn and maintain your website, WordPress is still the most flexible option. Thanks for watching. Hit like or subscribe if you'd like to see more reviews. See you next time at Tool Tester.